Alright everybody, welcome back. My name is Ben, and today we're going to be playing a little more Thaumcraft 4, and oh man, this is going to be fun. It's going to be fun, fun, fun. Almost can't wait to show you what I got going on. It's not this. I mean, I added a little pattern up here with some carpet, because I got just a ton of wool now. But no, that's not it. Today we're going to be talking about what I talked about at the end of my last episode, and that is mana beans, and they need to be sorted. The amount of mana beans my mana bean farm is generating is just nonstop. It's craziness. I could make it even crazier, but there's just no need. I'm getting a really good amount of mana beans as is. The need for some kind of system arose to sort them because I'm just getting too many and I don't know where to put them. So I was putting them all into these chests, and then eventually I would go and put them in other chests. I got like a chest full of this and this, and even a little bit of lag. That's okay. Even in here. So I've got a lot of mana beans, and I did not know what to do with them for the longest time. So that was until I kind of came upon this little thing that I used for my farm. I showed this off in my last episode, but I made this little thing here with these hungry chests over with water going across them, and that works out pretty good, really good, I gotta say. And so I decided to expand that to a huge amount and make a mana bean sorting system based off of hungry chests and water. And some other Thaumic Tinkerer toys that I've used before. It's all. I'm so excited. Hope you guys are excited, because I am. All right, let's go take a look at it. All right, I've made it right where I said I was going to. Here is my mana bean farm. Here, and golems are doing their thing. And here is the sorting tower. I don't know what I call it, a tower, or what I exactly want to call it, but yeah. Anyways, so let's go inside. Oh, I can't wait to show you. It's so cool. It's so fun. All right. So what we got going on here is a lot of hungry chests. And the hungry chests go all the way up, kind of spiral around the whole tower. And you can see they're labeled with a certain label. And they go all the way up from air. So we got all our air mana beans in here. And then Alienus, Aqua, so on and so forth. So how is this all happening? Well, let's take a look at the start. So you can see there's water going across the top of them. Just, that's how the whole thing works. Is the water going across the tops of the hungry chests? And the hungry chests essentially just act like hoppers, in that they just eat up whatever's on top of them, but they also make a wonderful noise when they eat it, which I love. Yep, in case maybe you just heard that, make a little chomping noise. All right, so what happens here? So let's just start at the beginning of our mana beans journey, if we will. You are stuck in a block. Get that mana bean. Thank you. All right, so this guy takes this mana bean, and eventually he'll put it into this chest. The chest is attached to a hopper. It's attached to another hopper, which is not optimal, but it's fine. What we're doing essentially just sends it down underneath the mana bean farm. Then it goes to another series of hoppers. So here's the last hopper chest. This hopper is pointing to a dropper. And you can see that dropper, whenever it gets an item in it, this comparator fires off. We then send the signal back to the comparator to shut it off. But then we also send that same signal to the dropper itself, and that causes the item to be spat out as such, right on cue. You see that? Planned it. Planned it. All right, so that water stream goes all the way to the back side of our farm. If I can get out of here. Fly. Okay, so we'll go over here. We'll just take a look at that. We'll look at that in a second. All right, so this is where these are where the beans go. You can kind of see one coming out now. It goes on top of this hopper and seemingly disappears. The hopper sends it into this thing. It's a transvector interface. That interface can teleport items up to 4 blocks away. So we then send the bean to here, to this hopper. Hopper sends it to another interface. It goes up and up and up and up and up. And this is where the dropper on the top is. It gets its items. It gets the bean, shoots them out. I don't have a roof yet, so just ignore that. You know what? Let's sleep through the night real quick, and I'll continue explaining. But the dropper essentially just drops the bean, shoots the bean out into the water stream up here at the top. I don't have it like finished yet, but I was just so excited to show it off. Because it worked almost exactly as I planned. Alright, so the hopper... I'm clutching the beans. Don't mean to, sorry. Alright, so the dropper, shoots the bean out into the water stream, and on the bean goes on its little journey all the way down to wherever it will get eaten up. So we can see here's our little bean here. He'll continue his way. Let's see, I don't know which one this is. It's funny, I was doing this today, and I was transferring a lot of these beans over from my main base to this just by hand. So I was getting very familiar with what bean color went with what. I think that is probably something that's... Maybe it's Machina? No. Machina's right here. But you can see it just keeps going on and on and around. It goes on top of every single chest we have until it will finally reach its destination. And who knows what that could be. Come on, little bean. Some of these chests, now I'll have to talk about the kind of the setup of this. It's a little more complicated than you might expect. Oop, I think our bean got eaten. I think it was Spiritus. Yeah, I think it was Spiritus. That one is something that starts with V. Maybe it's Validus. Near the end here. I'm thinking. Sometimes the beans don't always get eaten, but 9 times out of 10 they do. And I have a little fail-safe system in case they don't get eaten. See, that was Volatus. Vitreous. So we got one chest here, and if you kind of see behind that chest, there's actually a little water stream going down. And that water stream just essentially leads back to that water stream underneath this base. So that in case the item didn't get sorted at the right place, it can have another chance and another chance, because sometimes just the beans are a little funny in how they get sorted. So you might notice something like this. A sign can't be in the same block, so I had to put these up here. It's not optimal, but I wasn't about to just go back and start over with the signs, but the chests, and move everything so that all the signs looked perfect. This is good enough for me. So I know what everything is. Another little obstacle I ran into when I was making this was that I had, you might notice there's, in these corners right here, this chest is actually never gets an item in it. This chest is just full of cobblestone. That's to allow the beans to go over top of it. If you put a full block here or another, I tried to put just a regular vanilla chest, but if you try to do that, the beans get stuck actually, because the block or the chest isn't the same height as the hungry chest. So they would get stuck on the lip of the block, or they would get stuck in between the chests. If it was a normal chest versus a hungry chest, because they're probably just a little bit, one's a little bit taller than the other. I don't know which exactly. So the beans were getting stuck. So you want to keep an eye out for that in case you set up a system similar to this. You know, if you got applied energetics or one of the other sorting mods, then this is no big deal. But this is pretty fun, just using the straight up items from Thaumcraft and Thaumic Tinkerer just to get the well, Thaumic Tinkerer just gets the beans up there. You could use another method of getting the beans up here, if you, or just wherever the water stream starts. I like it too because it's only one water source block, and it goes all the way around. So I like that too. It's kind of a fun little way of doing it. So man, mana bean sorting. There's a lot of problems too. You notice I'm using leaves around the edges to kind of keep the water in place. I was using what was I using before? Fences, cobblestone fences, and that does not work. You have to have, not only does it have to hold the water back, it actually has to stop the bean from going through. Like a fence, isn't a whole block. It's just, the hitbox for it, if you can see it there, it's just maybe a third of the way. So the mana bean can actually fall into this little gap here. So you want to make sure you're using a full block if you're going to hold the water back somehow. And then yeah, this was fun. It's not something I would want to send up again. When I first saw the chests or the beans getting stuck in the water, I didn't know what I was going to do. I tried the regular chests, and I was kind of like, well, this isn't going to work. So I almost was going to demolish it, but thank goodness I didn't, because it's fun. It's fun to have it, have this whole thing now. Whole nice little area for all my mana beans. I might even move my my cauldron into here, because I mana beans is probably the thing I use in my cauldron the most. But we'll might get to that later. There's a few little things I have left to do on this. Obviously, I need to add a roof, and I need to add some lighting. And my daughter wants to make the floor look pretty, like I did in my base over there. But what I thought I might do is just really see this thing in action, and just to send a bunch of mana beans, just throw a bunch of mana beans at it and see what happens. So I thought the easiest way to do something like that would be to use magic mirrors. I happen to have a couple on me. So what we can do is we'll use these magic mirrors, and I'll put one. Oh, that there. I think I need to set up. I think I need to put that, yeah, like that, just in case the mana bean gets. Sometimes the dropper shoots it out at odd angles, I've noticed. So let's do this. Put the magic mirror right there. And then we'll link that to here. Did that link? Think it did. Yeah, because you can kind of see. Oh, there it did. There it definitely did. Okay, good. Okay, so now we got the magic mirrors linked, and that you just right click on the mirror in world to kind of get that going. And now what we'll do, we'll run over to my base, and we'll set up a little station for transferring over all these beans. That should be fun. All right, so we're going to just put, let's just put this here. Put it there. Oh, we can't put it on a fence. Oh, what a bummer. Where do we want to put it? Put it on a bomb. Nope, can't do that. Well, let's put a couple blocks down. That's fine. All right, let's do that. Okay. So this also needs some something to fuel it. So let's put this guy down here. And this is iter. This is what you need to power your magic mirrors. So we'll do that. And then Final step. Let's clear out our inventory a little bit so we can do a bunch of beans at once. That is the funnest way to do things, of course. Get rid of this and this stuff here. Oh, you don't lose your vials anymore. That's nice. I'll ramble on for just a couple minutes. Listen to the soothing sound of my voice. If you're tired, maybe just take a little nap. We'll get there in a second. Don't worry about it. Don't worry about it at all. Everything's gonna be fine and fun. Okay. Alright, so let's say I made a meme there. I don't know. Okay, great. Let's get a bunch. And we'll just start sending them through. And we'll just do this. We'll just do one round. Because this will be plenty. This will be plenty. Plenty of beans. I think even my system might get a little overloaded. But that's okay. I got plenty of hoppers and whatnot for backlog. So... should be fine. There you can see. That was kind of cool. A little bit of eider flowing into the magic mirror. Magic mirrors are cool. I can't wait till they can teleport you around. That would be very, very handy. Alright, so let's get going. Actually, the I heard there's supposed to be some kind of teleportation coming. I don't know if it's going to be in a future episode or not, but that's why I haven't built like a nether hub or anything for getting around real quick. Alright, so let's see. Oh man. Oh, this poor hopper. It's trying. Sending out items as quick as it can. Alright, and this thing, so the items are going up here. They're getting sent out probably as fast as this thing can handle it. Alright, awesome. And then the beans are just flowing. They're just flowing. Oh, and I'm catching them. Don't want to catch them. There you go. Oh. So you can see they just go down their merry way. And eventually they get sorted. It's kind of fun just to listen. Listen for the sound of the things eating them. Yeah. The num num num. Alright, but yeah, I think this is a good, I think this is a good system. I really like this. Obviously you probably wouldn't get this many mana beans at once, unless your farm was just enormous. You know, my farm's only too high. But it's getting me plenty of mana beans, more than enough for my purposes. But you can, you know, I could easily add a few more layers to this if I wanted to. It wouldn't be too big of a deal. Just 5 more golems and yeah, some wood and mana beans to plant. But that's, you know, no big deal. It's actually kind of cool to sit here and watch them go, because the golems are really dumb. You can kind of see they, like, if there's a mana bean on the other floor, they, like, try to get it, but they can't pathfind there. So they'll just sit there and spin in circles until the thing is eventually picked up, which I find funny. See, like, this one now is trying to harvest a bean, but he can't. So, it's just funny. The pathfinding of the golems is amusing to me, at least. Alright, but I think that is all we got going on today. This has been really fun to set up. It didn't take too long. There was obviously a few problems, but yeah, I think it went pretty well. Oh, got some beans here. Tell them. Good stuff though. So my last little thing is just gonna be some aesthetic work. Probably cover this cover this whole thing up, and probably just make this some kind of column. Maybe make it out of bricks. Who knows? And then red bricks, not these stone bricks. I really don't like using stone brick, but in this case, I had a bunch of stuff. I could kind of spruce it up with the cracked stone and the mossy down at the bottom. So yeah, get away from that. But yeah, I gotta add a roof, and we're gonna add some carpet downstairs just to make it look nice. And oh yeah, and then we gotta add a road. Can't go without a road. Gotta have these things. But yeah, I'm gonna call it though. I think that's my episode for you today. I hope you like this sorting system. You can obviously, you don't have to just use it for mana beans. You could use it for whatever you wanted to have sorted. As I'm using it for at my little farm over here. I'm using it a couple other places, just the water on top of the hungry chests. Oops, sorry about that. But yeah, you know, it can be used, has a lot of applications, is what I'm trying to say. So, but yeah, hope you enjoyed this episode. If you do, subscribe to my channel. I'm putting out a lot of episodes lately, and it's pretty fun to do. I like putting them out and just talking about Thaumcraft in general. And, you know, putting little videos out for this is fun for me. So if you like my video, subscribe, and, yeah, leave me a comment. Thumbs up the video at the very least. That helps me out a lot. And, yeah, we'll do something else next time. What was I going to do next time? Oh, next time we'll probably do something with villagers. I think a couple of videos ago I showed this little thing off. With all the villagers. Whoa, they're loading up all weird. Yeah, this little thing here with the villagers. We're going to do something fun with that. I've got a couple ideas in store. This should be pretty fun. So tune in for that, and I hope to see you then. Until then, take care. Bye-bye.